will come and go with us to the fourth chapter of Ephesians. The fourth chapter of Ephesians. The 22nd through the 24th verses. When you have found it, will you say amen? And the word of God reads, to put off your old self, which belongs to your former manner of life, and is corrupt through deceitful desires, and to be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and to put on the new self, created after the likeness of God, in true righteousness and holiness. Would you look at your neighbor and repeat this theme after me? Moving from membership to ministry. God bless you. You may be seated. Read the program. The program came from Ephesians 6. They sent me the letter. It came from Ephesians 4. But I believe God is going to work the two together. Amen. Membership. Membership. Ushers, you may be seated. There are clubs and organizations all over the world that exist because people desire to become members of them. Social clubs, fraternities and sororities, Masons and Eastern Stars, biker clubs, dinner clubs, civic organizations, the Kiwanis Club, the Rotary Club, the National Honor Society, the National Beta Club, the Key Club, all kind of athletic teams, gangs, membership, membership, membership. We all seek to be members of one thing or another. Many of these clubs and organizations are organized for service. They want you to serve. We join, we pay our dues only to serve. Why is it we join and pay these organizations to serve? Then we are also members of the church. And we have to beg you to serve. Won't work on the missionary society. Won't do outreach with the evangelistic team. Won't do anything in the church that requires love, time, or money. Why is this? We are members of the Missionary Baptist Church. Won't do missionary work the first. Won't work in any kind of ministry the first. My brothers and sisters, why is this? Why are we so willing to work in organizations where their mission, vision, goals, and objectives will pass away? Be members of God's church and not minister, not serve in a ministry, not just talking about preaching. Ministry is not just preaching. We won't feed the hungry. We won't provide shelter. We won't aid the elderly. We won't mentor some mother or college-bound girl. We won't mentor any misguided young man or a young man destined to matriculate to and through college. Why is this? I'll tell you why. Ministry requires a transformation. We don't mind serving in worldly organizations because we can serve and do the same old things we've been doing. We can continue to drink. We can continue to smoke weed. We can continue popping pills. We can continue committing sexual sins. We can continue mistreating each other. We can continue not loving each other, all while serving in these organizations. However, to minister as a member of the repentant, redeemed body of baptized believers, we must seek to live a life of righteousness. Live a life of holiness. We gotta turn down from worldly things. Turn down for what? Worldly things, and turn up for Christ. Turn up for the kingdom of God. The largest membership affiliated group in the world is the church. You won't pray with me. Boasting over 400 million Christians, Bible believing folks. What would this world be like if 400 million members of the church truly began living a life of ministry, serving the needs of God's people? What would it be like? Verse 48 would no longer be the desire of our television watch.